to me, it means matching your earning capability to your disposable income. The things that we all sort of would like to, the things that we work for, the ability to go out for dinner, the ability to take your kids to a show, maybe put your kids in sports. You know, those are things that add to our quality of life. Those are things that add to our community. But when affordability comes into play and we start to think, geez, I might have to cut out those sort of, you know, the good things that my job might afford me, to be able to just pay the lights or pay the hydro and pay the heat. And how do we make sure that we have, you know, a good amount of groceries in the house, right? So when people are starting to talk about, well, the affordability of everyday living, just absolutely being able to make ends meet. And it's a conversation that really you didn't hear about often, maybe even in the 90s or certainly in the 80s, but more and more we're seeing everybody being squeezed to no end. So there's something going on there that needs to be addressed. Where has our middle class gone? And how do we make sure that we you know, keep that vital component of our economy alive?
I think what's frustrating is that you make a good point with what happened to the middle class. You know, I know growing up with, you know, my parents, my mom actually could be home. And my father, Chrysler worker, he worked hard. It was enough. We had money to do those things with the family. So it would be, hey, this weekend we're going to go to Jackson Park and we're going to have this picnic and we're going to do all this stuff together. And now it's, well, honey, I don't think I can put you in that sport that you wanted, or we can't go to the movie, because as you mentioned, that you know, bracket of affordability seems to be, as you put it, squeezed. Do you see that potentially we can make a difference at some point in the near future?
I think we can. I think we have to.
You don't have a choice.
We don't have a choice. What's the alternative? I mean, it is again, it's such a vital component. And I think that in a province that is so rich, not only in resources, but in potential and infrastructure, there's no reason why we can't be an economic powerhouse again. But it's going to take some focus.
And you can do it.
We can all do it.
That's right.
We can do it.
That's right. So that it all works out together. Shenzi, thank you very much, as always.